Jesse Ventura, but that's not really mainstream. Yeah. He's got a show on True TV.
Right, he's
gone into some of the lesser known aspects of 9/11 conspiracy theory information.
Do we have any final photos to get taken?
And then National Geographic or Discovery, I can't remember which one.
National Geographic has.
Okay, good.
And I've actually got my business card there.
Okay, very good. You know, you're not a downer.
I think, you know, there's a tremendous amount of stuff that's overlooked. Like the first responders, they're not getting the medical attention that they need.
Let me ask you a quick question about all this, because I've asked myself this question before. Has any mainstream media network done an investigation on this?
A lot of foreign networks are picking it up.
Foreign networks, but like any American?
Quite a few, yes, but I mean, a lot of smaller stories, but I mean, kind of fitting all the puzzles together.
Jesse Ventura, but that's not really mainstream.
Yeah.
He's got
a
show on True TV.
Right,
gone into some of the lesser known aspects of 9/11 conspiracy theory information.
Do we have any final photos to get taken?
And then National Geographic or Discovery, I can't remember which one.
National Geographic has, huh?
And they did a special on it, but in my opinion, somebody has researched it. It was pretty much in certain ways. They tried through some kind of shady tactics to make people that have these questions look a little crazy.
You would be the expert
to have one. If I wanted to bring somebody, I'd be the one person that could speak.
Okay.
What's your gauge of architects and engineers?
His website is AE911Truth.
Here, let me write that down. Because I have, you know, the thing is, there have been some events we've gone to where people have stood up and shouted and yelled, but there are other times where people just come and say, hey, just read this. And so the last time...
It's also on the flyer that I gave you as well. There's a black and white flyer there.
Okay, the last time it happened, I was like, man, you know, we've got to find one person and have the discussion.
A lot of these people, like Charlie Sheen, for instance, he's actually tried to initiate a debate with the president. He's got 20 questions that he wants answered.
Yeah, right.
And, he's still wanting to carry on this conversation.
Yeah.
But then all you hear about is his stupid exploits, which make him look not like the best. Richard Gage of Architects and Engineers. Check that website out.
Okay.
He really is. It's AE911Truth.org.
Richard Gage.
Richard Gage. He's a really well-spoken expert that you can have on there.
Look what we're sending to Terry. Guys, one more book.
Oh, that's just not fair. Listen, it's great to meet you. Thank
appreciate
you for coming
it.
Out. No, yeah. I appreciate it. And again, you know what? Our whole thing, our whole mantra is let's just have a discussion.
Yeah.
And so...
I mean, I would love to be proven wrong with a lot of these theories, you know?
Right.
And, you know, we just haven't had the ample opportunity to...
Until you have the discussion, you're not... And until people have the back and forth, you're not going to...
What we really need is a live forum. It would be good on your show because you guys go live.
Right.
To have somebody like Richard Gage on so that it wouldn't be, there would be no chance of people doing editing in the background to make someone look dumb.
I understand exactly.
So that would be really important.
It certainly could be a ratings grabber, you know.
Joe,
Sorry to interrupt.
Thank you.
Her phone didn't come out.
Hey, thanks again.
Thank you.
You guys live around here?
You should have on Rhode Island for me. You should have Kurt Haskell on. Have you heard his story yet? The eyewitness of the Christmas Day bombing? This isn't about 9/11, but.
Kurt Haskell, the underwear bomber.
He's a lawyer, an American lawyer. He was in Amsterdam, and he saw the supposed terror suspect that Abdul Muttalib, whatever his name is, the young kid, led through security without a passport by what's been called the sharp dressed man.
Okay.
So look into that too.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate it.
Thanks, guys, for coming.
Yeah. Mr. Scarborough, I wanted to talk to you about something else. I know you don't really have the time now, but it's ICTS, the security company that's in charge of the airport, both in Amsterdam, Detroit, and was in charge of all the airports on 9/11, where the planes were
hit. ICTS?
It stands for International Consultants on Targeted Security.
Okay.
And somebody really needs to do an expose and, do some more investigative research. You can
Can I take this? Okay.
I scribbled my contact information,
okay,
but it bled through. But if you read on there, it's actually... really somebody needs to investigate this.
Okay.
I'm just doing a little bit of work on it, and it's pretty shocking what you find out. I mean, yeah, all like these airports, the same security
guy has a fascinating story, and a lot of the witnesses on the airplane that witnessed the whole Christmas thing.
Right.
A story that hasn't been told.
Okay. Very good.
Thanks so much again.
Thank you.
Take
care. Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Be safe.
Yeah, you too. Enjoy Boston.
With us.
Oh, no problem. I'm glad to get the info.
Good,
no
good.
Way. Good. Are you kidding me?
Hey,
what's up?
Hey.
Wow. Harvest restaurant.
Mm. I wish.
Do you have the address?
I can find it, but thanks.
I think we're going to get it to you.
Is he meat karate here?